John chapter 7, verses 53 to 8, verse 11. And they, the disciples, all went home while Jesus went to the Mount of Olives. At daybreak, he appeared again in the temple, and all the people gathered round him. He had taken his seat and was engaged in teaching them, when the scribes and the Pharisees brought in a woman caught committing adultery. Making her stand in the middle, they said to him, "Teacher, this woman was caught in the very act of adultery. In the law Moses laid down, such women are to be stoned. What do you say about it?" They put the question as a test, hoping to frame a charge against him. Jesus bent down and wrote with his finger on the ground. When they continued to press their question, he sat up straight and said, "Let whichever of you is free from sin throw the first stone at her." Then once again he bent down and wrote on the ground. And when they heard what he said, one by one they went away, the eldest first. And Jesus was left alone with the woman standing there. And Jesus again sat up and said to the woman, "Where are they? Has no one condemned you?" She answered, "No one, sir." "Neither do I condemn you," Jesus said. "Go and do not sin again." It may surprise you to learn that this well-known story isn't in all the earliest manuscripts of any gospel. For several centuries, it was free-floating until it was added, sometimes to Luke, more often to John, though the language, the Greek, is very different from the rest of John's Greek language. Yet there is no reason to doubt, I think, its authenticity. It was commented on by the early fathers, and it undoubtedly has the ring of truth. Sadly, of course, the woman's plight is being used here by the scribes and Pharisees to trap Jesus. Would he side with the Jewish law, which saw adultery as a capital offence, or with the Roman law, which didn't? It's rather like the question of taxes to Caesar. And Jesus doesn't answer directly. He pauses. He writes on the ground. We do not know what. And then, with a pointed question, disarms the accusers completely. "Let whichever of you is free from sin cast the first stone." And we are told they slunk off, the eldest first. It is as if those with the most experience of life, especially of its ambiguities, felt the full force of Jesus' remark. Alone with the woman, Jesus asked her, "Has anyone condemned you?" She answers, "No." "Neither do I condemn you," says Jesus. "Go and sin no more." It is a tender, pastoral encounter, though sometimes it's presented as a story of Jesus' generous forgiveness and his showing up of the censorious accusers. But it isn't quite that. Forgiveness as such isn't mentioned at all. Rather, confronted with the situation, Jesus refuses to judge. He shows mercy in refusing to condemn the woman, but points her to the possibility of a new way of life. It remains for her to decide which to do. Two verses of scripture come to mind. John chapter 3 verse 17. God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through him. And from the Psalms, Psalm 85 verse 10. Mercy and truth are met together. Righteousness and peace have kissed each other.